Alright, this is the assembly video for the EC1204 PV1.2 clock kit. I'll be doing a voiceover for this, but at the time of recording there was no audio recorded, or there was extremely loud humming. In a bad way. And here we get our basic components. We got a bag of LEDs, miscellaneous components, headers, switches, well, buttons, and the caps, and the very small tuning crystal. There's our ICs, a Atmel processor and a clock chip, battery holder, USB port, socket. There's the buzzer. And here's the seven segment 4-digit display. And this kit, came with surface mount components. And we're actually going to start with the surface mount components. Our transistors are in the black strip. And we've got capacitors and resistors, two different values of resistors. All right. We've got our components list out, which is making the camera a bit nuts. All right. So we're going to start by marking what our components are. And we're going to... Sharpie's not working all that great. Of course, everything's bleached out by the overly bright light. Our capacitors, but we're gonna get it wrong the first time. Of course, it turns out there's 4 20 picofarad capacitors in this kit. There are 2 crystals, and they are used for each one of the crystals. So I'm gonna mistakenly mark these 0.1, but in reality they're 20 picofarad, and the 0.1s are in the little 2-pack up there. Basically what I did was, both of them looked the same. I miscounted the number of 20 picofarad capacitors used. And just assumed they were all 0.1 decoupling gaps. Always good to read your instructions closer. Of course, when in doubt, I do have the meters to actually measure those capacitors, but I didn't. Again, referring to the documents here to get started. Again, we're going to start with the surface mount components. And this thing is truly layered. Again, this is where I make the mistake. This is not 20 pico, that it will be the actually the 0.1 micro. And that would be the 20 pico. Alright, for this I have a set of forceps. number to choose from. All of these are made out of metal. They're all ESD, whatever. Unfortunately, they are still magnetic. So you'll see in there where I have trouble getting some of the parts to release. But for this, I'm going to use the curved one. And looking to see where to start. So I'm making sure we're starting on the correct side of the board, because when it's finished, there will be parts mounted on the front and back of this board. This is the front side here, at least what I'm calling the front side. This will be where the LEDs are mounted, and the 7-segment display, well, the 4-digit 7-segment display, a header, which I assume is a programming header, and then there's a USB port, of course, is on the back side. I haven't actually looked to see if it's truly how it's being implemented on this kit, whether it's actually wired in or not. So we're going to start with our transistors. Provided we can get the plastic to peel. And it's being quite stubborn. I could have used the X-Acto knife, but then blood all over the place. That, what would be the fun in that? Of course, porn people would probably watch somebody only slice their finger off with the X-Acto knife, and might get more views. Alright, and well, you can see one of them's already tried to make a run for it. That's one. We're going to try to count out the number we need and then just dump those out. Carefully. So I don't want any of them to fall on the floor. I'd probably never find it, let alone find them on that mat. So yeah, if you don't have the hands for doing surface mount, this is probably not a kit for you. Yeah, I was tempted to, well, almost lost that one off the edge. I was really tempted to use the solder paste and the reflow oven, but there are actual surface mount components on both sides of this board. There's fewer on the back side with the battery, but there's still a few there. Lifetime supply of solder there. Something's not right. Don't have the right number of transistors. I need one more out. Now I got the right number, I think. Corralled in one location. I don't have any under the solder. Alright, I'm going to clean up the soldering tip. And we're just going to put a dab of solder on one of the terminals, middle terminal for each one of the transistors. This will make it easier to hold it in place to solder the other two. I find this technique works fairly well. It's not always the prettiest method, but quite effective. So we're now going to grab one of our small components. We're going to line the pins up with the solder down for. I'm using a 6x mag, as I think it's a 6x magnifier to help see the components. And of course, this is also with my using my reading glasses as well. Otherwise, I'd be really leaned into the shot here to see the components. We're just going to do it one, carefully do it one at a time, tacking that one leg. And then we're going to repeat that for each one of the devices, each one of the transistors. Trying to get the parts to lay flat on the circuit board. They tend to stand up when you're soldering them, whether you want it to or not. Get this guy turned around and then grab them. And then we can solder it in place. Got another one to solder on. Again, the same process. Solder down the one lead. Try to get the lay flat. Having a little trouble getting this in place. There we go, got it in place. Now this is a silicone mat that I got from Spark Fun. Plays havoc with the lighting. And now I'm just going back and I'm getting soldering the other two legs on. It's much easier. The part doesn't move around because it's already soldered on one leg, so as long as I'm not pushing too hard, I'm just applying just enough solder to solder the leads to the pads. And of course, we'll do that for all the transistors on the board, at least all of them on this side. I'll flip it over and do the others later. There's 9 transistors on there, 8 across that row, and then, yep, counting them there, yep, there's 8. Gonna locate the place for the 9th one, or have I already done it? Let's see. Again, referring back to the instructions, I do really recommend printing out the instructions on these kits, unless it is drop dead simple. But even the drop dead simple ones, I need a little. There we go. We put a little dab of solder to hold that center pin. We'll heat that up to hold the device. Just gonna apply a little more heat, get the part to lay flat, and then I'll solder its two legs as well. So I'm gonna look. I'm gonna pull the prints up again. I'm gonna actually the instructions for assembly. And I need to look at my resistor placement. But first, I'm gonna try to clean up around some of the pads. The solder wicks work generally works fairly well for this, although this is a rather wide wick. And I really didn't get the performance that I really wanted to tidy up some of these solder joints. But yeah, I guess my transistor is mounted.